By now, I'm pretty sure that most of us know that if we wanted to get the soft, beautiful light in our videos when we're shooting outdoors, we need to make sure that we're going at the correct time of day. The time of day when the sun is low in the sky, it's down there close to the horizon and creating that nice, soft, golden light that's going to create that beautiful light to hit your subject's face. But in today's video, I want to talk to you guys a little bit about when you don't have that option and instead you have to head out and shoot in that direct, harsh sunlight at midday or something like that. That light that everyone's like, ugh, don't shoot in that light. It's so horrible and unpleasing to your model. That's what we're going to be talking about today and how you guys can work with that light to still get a really nice look. So let's get into it. This video is sponsored by Storyblocks. A huge thank you to them for letting us create the videos that we do, but a little bit more on that later. So I just wanna get this out of the way. You can use bounce or you can diffuse light by having one of those round diffuser style things. If you've seen those photography assistants ever standing in the corner holding one of those big white round things, what they're basically doing is diffusing the light. Otherwise you could be bouncing the light to fill in the shadows. Now this is definitely a good option, and if you guys have a spare person to stand around and hold one of those, absolutely go for that. It can really give you a good result. But let's be honest, most of the time we're out shooting by ourselves. Maybe you have one buddy helping you out and we don't realistically have someone else that's gonna be standing around holding that. Before you head out and shoot, a couple of things that can really help you is shooting in a flatter picture profile means that you are gonna be able to get a better dynamic range and your highlights aren't gonna be as blown out as they might be if you were shooting in just a normal standard profile on your camera. So if your camera does allow, switch it over into something like a log footage, and that's just gonna help you a little bit. Another thing to keep in mind is not to overexpose and blow out those highlights, because once your highlights are gone, they are gone. You cannot bring them back. All of the detail in those blown out parts of your image are lost and there's nothing you can do. Rather slightly underexpose your image. You can always lift your shadows to bring a bit of that shadow back into the picture, and you can always throw a denoiser on to smooth out any grain in those shadows if you run into them later down the line. The first thing that I like to do when I'm shooting in direct sunlight is just get my model to stand in the position that I want to shoot them in and just turn them around a little bit, get them to face in different directions and notice how the light is hitting their face. You can often just shift the way that they're standing and it can give you a completely different look with all of that light hitting on their face. You can watch where the shadows are casting and pay attention to the shapes of the shadows on their face. You generally don't want any of those harsh shadows creating weird nose shadows or any raccoon eye style things. So oftentimes when they're facing more directly into that sun, they are going to be getting those harsh shadows and it's really not an appealing look for the model. Slightly get them to turn, and as they turn around, you can notice that the sun starts to shift and your model's face begins to fall into shade. And this is a much better look. You can see that the light is nice and soft on her face. It's even across her face and it's gonna make them look much better. Not only is this gonna show you where might be the most visually pleasing angle for them to stand in, it's also gonna give you a better understanding of what the light is actually doing and how it's affecting those shadows on your subject's face or whatever it is that you guys are shooting. Start to really figure out how those shadows are changing across their face and what ends up looking a lot better than others. This segues perfectly into my next tip, which is gonna be shooting backlit and making sure that your model is facing away from that really harsh light source like the sun. You can see that when the person is facing into that light, it really creates these harsh shadows on their face and it's gonna end up looking really bad. But by simply turning them around and facing them in the other direction and placing the light source right behind them so that you as the camera operator are facing straight into the sun, makes a much better look. You can see on the face now how much smoother and softer those shadows are and that light. It's much more of an even exposure across their face and it ends up looking way, way better. Honestly, I would be happy to shoot a little cinematic section or some photos like this. In my opinion, it really doesn't look that bad. And some of these shots actually turned out quite nice. Keep in mind, all of these photos and this footage was taken at midday, right around noon. So it's like the worst time in terms of lighting for the day, and they still turn out actually quite nice. The next option that you guys have is that you can find some sort of shade or some shadow being cast by something, whether that's a building or some trees, whatever it might be. By tucking in under that shade, it's gonna give you that nice soft light and you're gonna be able to get a much better look been in that shade rather than out in the direct sunlight. This might even mean that you guys need to plan your locations according to what time of day you might be shooting there. So if you do plan on going out for a shoot in midday, maybe think of a location that will work well and has a lot of shade to offer. Maybe it's in a forest or in a city where there's tall buildings and they're gonna be casting shadows. Might not be the best idea to head out to a vast open space like a beach or an open field, something where there's no shadows to work with. When you guys are gonna be shooting in the shade, keep in mind that you still wanna face your subject to the light source and wherever the light might be coming from. So you can see in this example, we are tucked away nicely under the shadow, but I'm still facing Hannah towards where the sun is so that I can get a bit of light to fill in that shadow and brighten it up a little bit. We don't want it to be too dark, so it works really nicely. And just keep in mind where the light source is coming from and try and face towards that light source. At times it definitely can be tricky when you guys are shooting in shade and your background might be in direct sunlight. It can sometimes be hard to get that even exposure and your background ends up being a little bit overexposed. So remember, this is where you might need to underexpose slightly, lift the shadows in post and add a bit of a denoiser. It's important to try and not completely overexpose that background, lose all those details in the highlights and not be able to bring them back once you're over in your editing software. Even if you guys plan your locations out perfectly for the time of day, sometimes it's just not an option to shoot that location at the time that you're gonna get the light that you need for those particular shots. And this is where something like StoryBlocks can really help you out. If you need to get particular shots that you just weren't able to capture, StoryBlocks has millions of assets with stock footage, sound effects, motion graphics, and so much more. When you sign up for StoryBlocks, you pay a small monthly subscription fee. And the best part is once you have that subscription, you get unlimited downloads. So no matter how many assets you guys want to use to add to your videos, you can get them all within that one monthly subscription. If you aren't already signed up for StoryBlocks, go and check it out. The link is going to be in the description. They have over a million assets for you guys to use. So if you guys are looking to take your videos to the next level, go and check out the link in the description. Otherwise, head over to storyblocks.com. The next thing I want to talk about when shooting in harsh light is to use that harsh light to your advantage and actually create something interesting out of it. So the whole reason behind like why that harsh light looks bad is because when you have those horrible shadows on your subject's face or whatever it might be, it almost looks like a mistake. It looks like you did something wrong and it looks like it wasn't supposed to be that way. So when you all of a sudden switch it up and you use those shadows intentionally, it doesn't look like it's wrong anymore. It can create like this stylistic thing and the viewer can see that you're actually doing that look on purpose. So what I'm talking about is you can see here in this shot where Hannah has her hand above her face and she's actually casting that shadow across over her eyes, creating quite an interesting look. You guys have probably seen me do this style of shot before because whenever I am in direct sunlight, I find it's one that really helps out. You can also see in this shot here where Hannah's hiding behind this like fence thing, I'm using those shadows to cast that shadow onto her face and create a bit of an interesting look. All of a sudden this makes it intentional and you can see that I almost did this on purpose instead of it looking like something that's wrong and something that I just overlooked. Now all of a sudden it adds to the photo and you can sometimes create some really interesting images by experimenting with this. You guys can take this and run with it, get as creative as you like and use those shadows to your advantage. You can do much more than just cast shadows onto your face. For example, if you're shooting some form of landscape, you could even have massive shadows casted from buildings highlighting certain parts of those landscapes, or you might be shooting out in the mountains and you could have the mountain casting a big shadow over the city but then the beach being still lit up by the sunset, for example. And it can create some really nice depth in shots when you have those different pockets of light. So remember in the beginning when I was talking about having a person to hold your reflector and bounce light to fill in those shadows? Well, you can also sometimes just find this wherever you're shooting. So for example, if you are shooting next to a big white wall, that is gonna fill in the shadows a huge amount and work a lot better than you actually think it would. So you can see here that we found this little white beach hut, and by getting Hannah to stand in front of it, we can get all of that bounce light to fill in those shadows and make it much more of an even exposure, even though she is being backlit. You can see here when she doesn't have that bounce filling in the shadows, it's not quite as nice of an image and by simply moving her over in front of the white wall, it really helps out and fills in the shadows. You can see in this shot, when we put her right next to that white surface, even though she's facing directly into the sun and still getting a lot of harsh shadows on her face, those harsh shadows are slightly filled in by that white surface, and it makes them slightly less contrasty and slightly less undesirable, giving it just that softer look and that more even exposure across her face. So when you guys are out shooting, be sure to be aware of the surfaces around you, because not only can you fill in the light, you can actually have dark surfaces that are gonna take away even more of that shadow and make it even darker. So if your subject is facing away from the light and they are facing into a really dark building, for example, that's gonna make it even worse. Their shadows are gonna be even darker than if there was nothing there at all. So look out for light surfaces, white walls or anything like that. They often work out really great and you'll be surprised how much of a difference it actually makes. That's gonna be it for this one, guys. I hope the next time you are out shooting in direct hard light, these tips can help you out. Remember to check out Storyblocks. They are going to be linked down in the description. They truly are an amazing platform for creators like you and I. And if you aren't signed up already, you are missing out. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you in next week's video. Peace.